Students, next we discuss about graphs. Graphs, okay? So, in this graph, we discussed mainly the representation of the motion of the object. That is, the object move in uniform motion or at rest position or in uniform acceleration. Then what is the velocity, acceleration of the object. So, by using graphs, we can easily discuss it, we can easily find what about the distance or velocity of the object at that time. Okay? So, first of all, there are three types of graphs are there. XT graph, first one. Second one is VT graph. Third one is AT graph. First one is XT graph, means position time graph. Second one is velocity time graph, that is VT graph. Third one is acceleration time graph, is AT graph. The mostly you have to use XT and VT graphs. Okay. So first of all, we discussed first one is XT graph. That is distance time graph or position time graph also. Okay. So first we take, in case the body is at rest position, then what is the representation of the graph? First one, if an object is at rest, then what is the rest position representation of the graph? In the graph, first of all, we draw the graph. This is origin, this is x-axis, and this is y-axis. Along the x-axis, we can take time, and along the y-axis, we can take position or distance of the object, given object. So that's why we have to write what is the rest, the body position does not change with respect to time. So that's why the position is remains constant, that is x naught. Then time will be increases, then position is remains constant. So this is the representation of the object is at rest position. Okay. So this line is parallel to x-axis, means the body is at rest position. Okay, students. Now we have to discuss the second one, second graph. If an object or any body is in uniform motion, then what happens? What is the representation of graph? X-axis, we have y-axis, along x-axis time, along y-axis we can take position or distance. So in this situation, what is the representation of the graph? So uniform motion means the object is moves with constant velocity. Then the object says to be in uniform motion. So that's why the position of the object is starting from zero, and as time will be increases, then position also equally increase. That is, which gives a straight line from the origin. And also we represent, for suppose the at zero time the position of the object is maximum x naught, then in this situation also object graph will be representing a straight line motion. Okay. So we have to take only one. So object is starting from zero, then we'll represent this one. Object will starting from maximum when we represent from this one. So in this graph, what is this graph gives? This graph gives slope. Okay. So the slope of this straight line is small values. So this is dx, small dx, and this is small dy. That is, this is small dt, and this is small dx. Okay. So dt, that means small interval of time. In small interval of time, we have to find the slope. So this is makes an angle theta. So this is slope of straight line, which is equal to tan theta. Tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Then we have to write dx by dt. Dx by dt. Now, this dx by dt is nothing but the rate of change of position or the rate of change of distance. So that's why this is called velocity. It's called velocity. So we have to say that from this graph, the xt graph gives, that is graph, not graph gives, xt graph slope gives velocity. Distance time graph gives velocity. Okay, very important point. Now we have to take another situation, the object is in uniform acceleration, then what is the representation of graph? If an object is in uniform acceleration. So that's why we have to write this one graph is representation in this situation, uniform acceleration, that is, position of the object will be drawn in the shape of this one, like this. Okay? So, we have to take a slope at any point on this one, that is, we have to draw a straight line at any point P on the straight line, on the curved line, which gives slope of the given one. So in small interval of time, this is dt and this is dx. Then this is also theta. Now slope of this value, slope is equal to tan theta equal to dx by dt, which gives v instantaneous velocity. Why? Because we have to take a small interval of time at point P. So, at a particular instant of time, you measure the velocity. So, that's why this slope gives instantaneous velocity in uniform acceleration. Okay? Now, the fourth one. If an object is in uniform retardation or deacceleration. So in this situation, we have to write or represent the graph is time position. So that's why the position of the, that is time will be increases, then position will be increases, but it becomes finally stopped. Because of deacceleration, means after the brakes applied on the object, then what happens? After some time, their position is becomes rest position. So that's why you have to take this one. Okay, stop that one. And finally, fifth graph is the important graph. So in case the object will move with upward motion, that is, if an object thrown vertically upward, and we know that a body projected vertically upward from the ground, then it will be get back to the earth surface. So in this situation, what happen in this situation, we have to write, so object will thrown from the ground and it will be reach maximum height and it's again into the earth. So that's why the position of the object will be increased and again it will be moved downwards. So this is starting from zero, at zero time, then it will be ending time, at the ending time its position also is becomes zero. Okay, so that's why we have to represent the graph for this one. Okay, okay, so this is origin. At zero time, this is at zero position. So the graph starting from origin. Now as time increases, position of the object or distance of the object is also increases. So that's why the graph will be move in this direction and uniform retardation, because of its velocity finally becomes zero. So same as this representation. Now the distance of the object will be reaches to same position, that is the position as time increases, then it will be reaches to same position. That's why we have to write the graph will be reaches to same position of the x-axis. So this one will be maximum height reaches by the object, that is this one. Okay, and this is the time for ascent, TA representation, and this is for time for descent, T suffix D representation. Why? What is time of ascent? Time of ascent means the body, the time taken by the body to reach maximum height from the origin. Similarly, same as this, 0 to maximum height time representation on the x-axis gives time of ascent. Similarly, it gives time of descent. And the total time T, that is this total time T, is represent time of flight capital T. Time of flight capital T. Okay, students. So this is the graph for position and time graphs. Next, we discussed velocity and time graphs also. So, same as this representation will be explained in the next VT graph. So, in this, we remember some points. One is, XT means position time or distance time graph. Now, this graph gives, that is this graph slope gives, what gives? Which gives velocity. Okay, and the body is at rest position. We have to place a straight line on the x-axis. Okay, in case, this first case, any vehicle is at rest position, this is your place. Okay, so the distance between you and the car is some x naught. So So this x naught will not change after some time also. So that's why we have to place this one, x naught distance. This is x naught. In case you are in the car, you are in the inside the car. Okay? That is, you are in the driver. Now in this situation, you are at rest position in the car, and the car also is at rest position on the ground. After some time also, you are in rest position. Then what happened? This graph, this straight line is nothing but this one. Because position x or x naught is becomes zero. That is, this is the origin. Your place is origin and car place is also origin. Then that's why we have to write x naught equal to zero. So this zero, after some time zero, after some time zero, after some time zero, after some time zero position. Okay? So you remember this point also. Okay? Thank you.